Okay, so I made like an intentional community purchasing situation to figure out the percentage of ownership per. So let's say you have a house and you decided that you're going to go ahead and make an intentional community with it, invite people to co-own it with you. So you're like, how do I figure out how much percent? It's pretty simple. You go with your basic property value, like if you pull a Zillow or something, and then how much your mortgage is. Okay, so let's say that would be a mortgage. So you have this to that. Then, so the main owner itself, you just do the subtraction from that. You end up with 59% for that main owner. So now you're looking at, okay, I have 59%. Then you're saying you want to now about the next 41% you have to divvy out between the mortgage itself because you want these people to pay off all the rest of the mortgage, so because that's less out. So then you would have once in the, and so their percentage is based upon their percentage of that amount, which is in this instance, I'm sorry, this no this I'm sorry, it's based upon the percentage of the total home. Yeah, I went off that one, the total home and property value. So here you put in 10,000. Now I thought if I put in 10,000 it would be a little bit more than that, but a little less than that, but it seems to be giving me 3,800. The C16 divided by is giving the person 3.85. See, I would immediately thought 10% is 26,000. I guess so. I guess so. So that, yeah. So it ends up being that 3.85. Okay, so then I threw in some names. So these people are all going to co-purchase the IC. And with that, you just maintain these numbers of your ownership, wealth value that you put through. You said, okay, I put in 20. Well, then you're always going to be the 769. So anytime there's a bill, and I mean a bill, like for, let's say you decide to build an upper level in the house, you would pay 7.69% of that, whereas the main owner would pay 59.4%. So it seems pretty yucky for the main owner in that moment. But the only way, that would be the only fair way, unless the main owner says, okay, well, since somebody else is going to end up buying my share and whatever, or portions of my share, because I don't have that much to pay for an upper level. So, and anyway, they say an upper level doesn't even add value to a house anymore. So, any hoot. So it's all of these things. So, let's say you're going to go put new siding. Fred is going to pay 3.85% of that Home Depot bill. So it just is helpful. Over here, and then you're like, okay, well, how about work allocation? That's a big question because a person is they're working, and one person it paid 10,000, and another person paid, in this instance, we have somebody paid 40. Shouldn't the person who paid 40,000 work far less? And shouldn't the person, the main owner, who paid 100 and how much did they pay? 154. Shouldn't they pay less? Absolutely. So you come up with what is the price? There is a value moment where you decide if you've paid 50% or more. Then you don't have to work. Okay, so you had to come up with this moment number. So I came up with 50% being the when work stops. That's the work stop moment. Excuse me. Now, obviously, that main owner whoever has 50% or more share, they can obviously keep working. It's just a guideline, that's all, to keep the people who paid very little to remember that they have to work more, just to allocate the difference. So here you have to help allocate the difference in the ownership. So let's say, so you have Fred here. He only paid the 10,000, so he has to work 40 hours. And that's because I put the maximum hours here at 40 per week on the house per person. So there's a max per person. Now you could put that any number you want. You could put it at 20, you could put it at 50. But right there, I put it at 40. This also does a sum of all the hours that the people work, every single one of them. So that's kind of neat. So the house is getting 200 work hours a week or whatever. Okay, so then these all can be changed. You see where it says 5 to 12? Oh, that can be changed. And that's just saying that if your percentage of ownership is under 5%, then you're going to have to work 40 hours. That's what it's coming out of. It's giving you the sum of one, which is the same as that. This is the total number of that one. Otherwise, if you work 12, I'm sorry, if you put 12.5% in, it's going to give you a drop off. So it's going to give you a tiered effect. Like, remember, because the 50%, anything above 50 is a level 6, and you don't even have to work any longer. So that would be a zero. This was the easiest way for me to do this. So here that one is between 5 and 12.5, they have to work 30 hours. Somebody who has 12.5% ownership to 25%, they have to work 20 hours. And then the 25% to 37.5, they have to work 10 hours. So it just seemed fair to me to do something like that. Because otherwise you get bickering and you're like, well, you only paid this much and you're not working and blah blah blah. And so if you're not pulling your weight and you're not doing your work, I hate to say it's a timestamp, like those punch cards, but if you're not pulling your weight, you're not doing that, then you would have to be voted out by the group and say, well, you're gonna have to sell your portion off. We're gonna have to sell your portion off. That's just the way it goes. You would get your, when you sell, how does that work? You get your money back, but you have to bring somebody in at the same. So you would get your 10,000 back, but or whatever the value. Obviously, it's a property value. Remember, it could increase to 360 in the time that Fred was holding it, and then they decided to taper off and not work 40 hours. So let's say he got real lazy. So, and then he was forced to sell it. So the 10,000, maybe it's 15 by then, that in value. So he would have to find somebody that was a 15 in value, or two people that were 7,500 in value. So anyway, that's it. So I'm going to put the little link out there. I think it's pretty cute, and it just tells you your allocations. How much you work, how much you own of the property, and this is how much you would pay on any kind of upgrades. So the Schwami guy put 40,000 in, he would have to pay 15% on those upgrades. And that's just an easy way to go about it. Okay, all right. Thank you for listening. Damn it. I don't think it works.